imagine
humanity in the, you know, the coming decades, we obtain a really thorough knowledge of how our brains function. What impact would that new knowledge have on our worldview, our view of ourselves? Well, it's a tough question. I think, well, there are probably lots of answers. One obvious answer is that we're physical. I think the physicalist philosophy, you know, the idea that we're just physics and chemistry and nothing else, you know, you don't need spirituality or whatever, souls. I think that idea will go by the board. And as people become more sophisticated and better educated, so physicalism becomes more widespread. And that, I mean, I've lived in Europe and America, and I see that philosophy far more developed in Europe than it is in the US. So, but there may be some surprises. Like, what impact would a greater knowledge of neuroscience have on ideas like free will, memory, motivation, ability to learn, you know, the unconscious, stuff like that? There may be some surprises that, you know, we just didn't expect, and maybe a couple of decades from now, our view of ourselves will be quite different from what we have today. I wouldn't be at all surprised that happens, but ask me to predict what these surprises will be. Well, if I knew it, they wouldn't be surprises, but I expect to be surprised, put it that way. To be honest, I don't have a lot of interaction with the masses, the peakers as I call them. But when I have, I get shocked at the level of ignorance. You know, a lot of people, they really do believe that you know, there's no evolution, Darwin was wrong, that there's a soul and, you know, there is life after death and, you know, all this stuff that I just can't relate to because I've, you know, grown up with science. It's I live, breathe science. A genetic scientist, born and bred, I suppose. So, even if all this evidence comes out, you know, you know the saying, you can take a horse to water, but you can't make it drink. So, you can't force these people to absorb this new knowledge. They may choose not to. In the movie Transcendent Man, there was a Stanford professor, you know, a very bright guy, obviously Stanford, you know, one of the top schools in the world, who was a neuroscience professor who claimed that he was strongly religious, you know, real Christian. Now, when I was a professor in Utah, which is a very religious Mormon state in America, I had a head of department, a Mormon, a converted Mormon, right, by choice. He'd become a Mormon by choice, and obviously very bright because he's a full professor, tenured and so on. And he was a mystery to me. How could somebody believe what he believed on the religious front and yet be so smart intellectually? And for me, that's just evidence of how modular the brain is. So occasionally when I was talking with him, I'd see flashes in his eyes of fear. I mean, it would just be there for a fraction of a second. Maybe he wasn't even conscious of it, but I'd sense this flash of fear across his eyes when we're talking about, you know, these kinds of issues, you know, physicalist, and he's saying things like, oh yeah, there can't be a conflagration, there can't be an Arctic war killing billions of people because we are God's children and he will protect us, you know, and then flash of fear. So I guess a lot of people believe what they want to believe. And I suspect that the rational, critical, cynical parts of their brain are cut off, disconnected from the whatever the religious aspects of their brain that want to believe. Whereas with other people, I think that permeable, that membrane is more permeable than for others. So I think that for me is, being cynical, is proof or quasi-proof of just how modular the brain is, you know, quasi-separate compartments doing things independently of each other. And a lot of people think that the basic architecture of the brain is that it's just an evolved historical kludge, just one fudge factor on top of the next that evolved and survived because it was successful. And so you've got all these quasi-independent faculties in the brain. Like people can have contradictory ideas simultaneously in their heads, and if they don't connect the two ideas, you know, X and not X, if they don't connect them, then you get this belief in X under certain circumstances, the belief X comes out, and in other circumstances not X comes out, but unless you get some new circumstances where these two clash, and someone, for example, points out to you, hey, do you realize that you believe in X and not X? Then they're forced to confront the issue. But that may be very disturbing. I mean, you go up to a priest and you say, look, the evidence is that the cultural anthropologists, the anthropologists of religion, they will tell you that humanity has invented about, order of magnitude, about 100,000 different gods over the broad sweep of history, over the whole planet, right? And Dawkins is rather famous for saying, well, all of us are atheists with respect to all those 100,000 gods except one, right? Most people believe in something. And then he makes the amusing comment, well, atheists just go one god further, right? So, good point. But I shouldn't push too hard. I'm certainly not a theist, but I'm very open to deism, as I've said before. I see quasi-scientific evidence pointing, giving strong hints in that direction, that maybe there is a creator, a designer. And wouldn't it be nice if science could get a handle on that hyper-creature that designed the universe. And I see that notion as more plausible because maybe, just maybe, the artifex that we humans give the kickoff, get them started, who knows, maybe in a highly advanced form they could become such superb scientists and engineers that they might just be able to design and build a universe. And who knows, if that's possible, maybe some artifact in some other universe designed, built our universe, right? So therefore, that artifact in another universe is our creator. So that other artifact is then a deity, right? By definition, it created us. So it makes the notion of deism more plausible, not as... A lot of scientists in earlier decades dismissed the notion.